Namaskar and welcome to this very special episode of Raga Pariche. This happens to be the 30th episode of Raga Pariche, and so we decided to make it a special one. The first very different thing is I have Yashasvi with me, who is going to sing, and Charu Phadke, who is going to be on the tabla. So we have a great ensemble today. And we will be going well beyond just explaining the rag, but we will also be, you know, presenting different compositions to show various facets of Bhairavi. What is going to change hereafter in case of Raga Pariche is that Raga Pariche is going to be premiered every Saturday. So we will have a new rag every Saturday. It will be premiered exactly at the same time, every Saturday evening, 7 o'clock Indian time. Another different thing will be that we won't have the chat session after the Raga Pariche session. And we would request you to put in all and any of your questions onto the forum of Ragasphere. You know, this is where we want to now create the forum on the Ragasphere website as the central place where all our queries and all our explanations come together. On one side, we have this Raga Pariche series. On the other hand, we have the Sunte Raho Zoom workshops. And of course, within Sunte Raho, there is a lot of live action which happens, live interaction which happens. But in case of Raga Pariche, you can post your questions onto the forum there on ragasphere.com. So ragasphere.com will be the place where you ask your questions, you answer others' questions, and you discuss. So I think that's the place to look forward to. So what we are going to do now is I'll explain as usual. I'll start off with an explanation of Rag Bhairavi and how it happens. And then we will get into the compositions one by one. There will be three or four, or depending upon the time. We will have a few compositions which will, you know, show different facets of Bhairavi. Yes, so let us get on with Bhairavi. Now, Bhairavi enjoys a very significant place in the culture of India. It's culturally, it is extremely significant. You know, the most important significance of Bhairavi is it is used as an ending of a concert. So most concerts would end with a Bhairavi. So if you see a singer or a instrumentalist starting off with a Bhairavi, you can imagine that he is going to end the concert after this. Now, there could be various reasons for this, you know. I think of a couple of reasons. Number one, Bhairavi is normally sung in the mornings. The time allotted to Bhairavi is the morning time. And probably in the old days, the concerts used to go on through the night. And then when you near the end of the concert, you know, it's daybreak, you get into the morning, and then you end with Bhairavi. Another logic a friend of mine gave me was quite different. She said that in a concert, if a singer has to sing many rags, one after the other, then to, you know, make it develop better and better, normally what is done is after you have sung a rag, supposing you sing a rag with all Shuddha Swara, then the next rag should introduce one Komal Swara. And so on, you know. So if you have one rag starting off with all Shuddha Swara, then the next rag chosen is with one Komal Swara added. So naturally, the next one after that would have a couple of another Komal Swara added. And so finally, when you come to the end of the concert, everything is Komal. And that is Bhairavi. Bhairavi is the rag which uses all these swara in their Komal versions. So that is Bhairavi. Bhairavi is extremely popular. It is the, you get Drupads in Bhairavi. There are Khayals in Bhairavi. Normally Madhyalaya Khayals. There are not many Vilambit Khayals in Bhairavi. A lot of Thumris in Bhairavi. All the types of semi-classical songs, you know, Thumri, Dadra, and Chaiti, Kajri, Hori, and all that. And you have, because of this specific cultural association also, and we will get into the Bhairavi structure. It is extremely popular in the light music also. Meaning the Hindi film industry, again, going back to the 70s and before that, you know, really, really used Bhairavi to a large extent. So we will know, you know, when we look at the structure of the Bhairavi, why this happened. So let us start looking at the structure of Bhairavi now. So as I said in the beginning, Bhairavi is all swara in their Komal versions. So this is my sa. This is only the set of the swara used in Bhairavi. And we all know what the chalan of a rag does to a structure of a rag. So let us look at the chalan of Bhairavi as a rag. So normally is omitted in the Aroha. Sagama or and then there is a very peculiar Andolan to the Gandhar. Sa ga ma ga ga ma ga ma re sa ni sa. So this is how the Bhairavi normally begins. And then ga ma dha pa, that's the next phrase. Then, when you go into the Uttaranga towards the Sa, Gama Dha Ni Sa, Gama Dha Ni Sa, You could also go. Gama pada nisa. So this is the Chalan of Bhairavi. So this is the purest form of Bhairavi, which was the original version of Bhairavi, where you are using all the komal swar. Over the years, over the last few centuries, I must say, that, you know, a lot of things went on changing. And then a lot of Shuddha Swara are getting added to the structure of Bhairavi. And today, in fact, we almost treat Bhairavi as a rag with all 12 Swara. So Bhairavi uses all 12. But then not randomly, there is a system to that. So let us just, you know, briefly see how this can be done. So let us look at the... If I have to add the Shuddha Re... Sarega... And just as we added the Shuddha Re, you can then add the Shuddha Daivat, because that's the counterpart in the Uttaranga. You could add the Tivra Madhyam in a beautiful way. You will find this done normally in the Thumris. The Thumris also add the Shuddha Nishad. Very sparingly used. Shuddha Gandhar, I think it's probably the most discordant in the whole structure, and you won't find many people using the Shuddha Gandhar, really, you know. So this is Bhairavi, you know, using all 12 notes beautifully, and this flexibility and this malleability of the rag is probably what has made it, you know, so very popular for the light music and the semi-classical music. So you have a lot of Thumris and umpteen dozens of Hindi film songs in Bhairavi. So that was Bhairavi for us. I'm going to begin with a very traditional bandish, a khayal bandish in teen taal, Karana Mori Lagi. And now from a Khayal Bandish, we move to a Thumri.
Yes.
Yashasvi is going to sing a Thumri for us, Bhairavi. This is in Adha Taal.
Adha Teen Taal.
Adha Teen Taal. Yes. So over to Yashasvi for a Bhairavi Thumri.
Madhya.
Okay.
Thoda bada.
Now you will notice that the Tanpura is tuned to the Madhyam. So it is playing Shadja Madhyam.
Yes.
And a lot of Thumris and the semi-classical forms are sung from the Madhyam. Meaning, the Madhyam is taken as the Sa and then you build up from there. So
yes.
let's see by Yashasvi doing that.
Re 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 na re da na de
Mo pe
डारो ना डारो मो पे बाटे चलत पिचकारी चलाया ना करो बाट चलत पिचकारी चलाया ना करो होरी के दिनन में होरी के दिनन मोपे रंग सुनो सुनो डारो ना डारो ना डारो मोपे रंग सुनो सुनो कुवर कन्हाई पन घट पे आया ना करो डारो ना डारो ना डारो मोपे रंग सुनो सुनो डारो ना डारो ना डारो मोपे रंग डारो ना डारो ना डारो मोपे रंग सुनो सुनो डारो ना डारो ना डारो मोपे रंग सुनो सुनो डारो ना डारो ना डारो मोपे रंग डारो ना डारो ना डारो डारो ना डारो ना डारो मोवे
वाह वाह क्या बात आफ्टर दैट वंडरफुल भैरवी फ्रॉम यशस्वी ठुमरी वी गो ऑन टू अ बंदिश की ठुमरी अ बंदिश की ठुमरी हैज अ लॉट मोर वर्ड्स टू इट इट हैज अ मच thicker lyric, if I can say so, and it has a much tighter structure to follow. So we are just going to play the structure of the bandish, and I think you will make out the very different expression, you know, when I play it on the flute and she sings out the words. There is a very distinct expression to both of these. So, Bandish Ki Thumri, this was a composition by Ratanjan Karbua. Thank you.
मन घाटू पे जल भरन रि मैं कैसे जाऊं दया रे दया मगरो को कारो कन्हाई दया रे दया मगरो को कारो कन्हाई पकड़ा था मोरी कलाई खींचत अब ने और डरत गरे बाई ले तलाज शरम बीच डगर अब मैं तो हारी हारी पन घट पे जल भरन रि मैं कैसे
Yes, and finally, we present Tarana jointly again.
Correct.
And again, we will just present the basic composition. But you will again see very different expressions coming from the instrument and from the words. So, just an attempt. परत मुखड्याला आलोच नाही आता नाही येणार परत ती बात
ठीक आहे
आता वेगळं होईल काहीतरी. मग काय
Yeah.
प्रियदर्शिनी भैरवी प्रियदर्शिनी रजनी रागिणी मोहिनी हे माते वरदे शक्ति दे हम कला उपासकनागे तुम्हें गुलाल आज नृत्य गीत वाद्य संगीत की सेवा करे यही कामना मनोभावना उदित नन तन देरना उदित नन तन देरना उदित नन तन देरना तन देरना तन देरना तन देरना
Thank you so much.
Thank you.